Oh, it was horrible! The behavior modification, electric shocks, the near constant beatings, actually administered by Betty herself. I'm telling you, getting sober blows.
Psst, Dick, we're alive!
Oh, great. Hello, Dick Cummings here. You know, why the hell do you always let me talk when you know we're on the air?
Because the Romp wants it that way. Plus, I think it's kind of funny.
I see, fair enough. Hey, the old Dick Cummings would have jumped over this desk and stuck his foot clean up your ass for that remark. But not the new me. Oh, no! So before we get started, just a few words about my personal life. Look, I could give you a big lecture about the virtues of sobriety, going on and on about how you need to respect yourself.
Hi, need someone to talk to? I'm waiting for you. I want to hear all about your big throbbing.
Honey, dinner's ready.
Okay, Mom! I'll be down in a minute!
Tonight's Romp Files takes you straight to the gates of hell, then opens those gates and forces you to peek in. The story begins in a small town in Alabama.
Hear that racket?
I listened to a little heavy metal in my day. Hell, I even gave head to most of the members of Deep Purple. But this Christian rock has turned my son into a monster!
Hi, Mom. Jesus loves you.
Please, Earl, stop it!
I used to listen to Ozzy and just wanted to commit suicide and get high. But since I got into Christian rock, I make straight A's and I stopped doing drugs.
I don't know you anymore. This is the devil's work.
It seems Satan works in mysterious ways, hiding his messages sideways in Christian rock and roll music, tearing families apart by making delinquent youths non-delinquent.
Get out! Get out of my house!
Besides just sucking, this music is destroying an entire generation of would-be criminals and addicts.
Hey, ho, here we go, psychedelic Bob.
All right, quit your yapping. Bob couldn't be here today, so I'm here filling in. And yous could call me Uncle Rocky.
But where's Bob?
He ain't coming, so stop you whining. Hey, what did I just say? All right, then, today we're going to learn all about, gunpowder. Okay, you like guns, do you? Yes, smart kids. All right, guns are our friends. And the word gun is in the word gunpowder, you see. So you got your bullets, and you just put them in here.
Oh, hey, how you doing, kids?
What the hell, a rat? I'll kill you, you stinking varmint. That'll teach you, you dirty old shit.
So what are you waiting for? Pick up the phone and...
Sweetie! These dishes aren't going to do themselves.
Mom, I'm trying to help people masturbate.
All right. And our salute to Psychedelic Bob continues. Bob, we've dug up a lot of old footage on your life, your lows, and your many, many highs.
It's been a long, strange trip, that's for sure.
Okay, let's take a look.
Thank you.
rule! What? Wow! Bam! Balls! Fly, man! I can fly! This is far!
You've led a wild life, Bob!
No thanks! Not hungry!
Tell us about your childhood.
My childhood? Well, Mr. Giantfoot, I grew up on a farm and there were flowers in my hair.
Pero Maria... Mis ojos. Mis ojos.
Su ojo. Mi ojo, Arturo. Mi ojo.
Ay, María, qué lástima.
Quiero poquito huevos. Quiero poquito huevos.
Ay, un grande ratón. Socorro, socorro.
Oh, yeah? Tell me what you're gonna do.
We're interrupting our programming to bring you the latest on a giant rat that's terrorizing the city. We don't know why he is giant or why he is smashing things, whether he's smashing because he's giant or he's giant because he smashes. I'm no expert, but I'll bet that radioactivity is involved somehow. Oh, I almost forgot. The humanity! Oh, the humanity! To have stopped in front of a television station. Oh, oh my gosh!
In my eye, I can't see! Dig! Dig! Oh no.
Everything around me became suddenly unreal. As if in a dream. Unreal. As if in a dream, as my brain seemed to be held in the...